You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yamet, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Friday, the 1st of July, 2022, 13th week in ordinary time. And participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Irene Nayamechirwa, celebrating her birthday today from Lusaka, Zambia, text for us the first reading. Godfrey Wegumisa from Kampala, Uganda, celebrating his golden birthday today, text for us the responsorial psalm and proclaiming the gospel is Father Delphinus Felician, a Salesian of Don Bosco working in Moshi, Tanzania. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
The first reading. I'll send them a famine on the land, not a famine of bread, but of hearing the words of the Lord. A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amos chapter 8, verse 4 to 6 and verse 9 to 12. Hear this, you who trample upon the needy and bring the poor of the land to an end, saying, when will the new moon be over, that we may sell grain, and the Sabbath, that we may offer wheat for sale, that we may make the ephah small and the shekel great, and deal deceitfully with false balances, that we may buy the poor for silver and the needy for a pair of sandals, and sell the refuse of wheat. On that day, says the Lord God, I'll make the sun go down at noon and darken the earth in broad daylight. I'll turn your feasts into mourning and all your songs into lamentation. I'll bring sackcloth upon all loins and baldness on every head. I'll make it like the mourning for an only son and the end of it like a bitter day. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord God, when I'll send a famine on the land, not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Lord. They shall wander from sea to sea, and from north to east. They shall run back and forth to seek the word of the Lord, but they shall not find it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, taken from Psalm chapter 119, verses 2, 10, 20, 30, 40, and 131. The response is taken from Matthew chapter 4, verse 4. And the response is, man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
Man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
Blessed are those who keep his decrees. With all their hearts they seek him.
Man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
I have sought you with all my heart. Let me not stray from your commands.
Man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
My soul is consumed with longing at all times for your decrees.
Man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
I have chosen the way of faithfulness. Your decrees I have upheld.
Man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
See, I long for your precepts. Give me life by your justice.
Man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
I have opened my mouth and I sigh, for I yearn for your commands.
Man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
Those who are well have no need of a physician. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 9, verses 9 to 13. At that time, as Jesus passed on, he saw a man called Matthew sitting at the tax office, and he said to him, "Follow me." And he rose and followed him. And as they sat at table in the house, behold, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat down with Jesus and his disciples. And when the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" But when he heard it, he said, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice, for I came not to call the righteous, but sinners." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us begin with the first reading of today. At the beginning of this week, I explained to you the context of Prophet Amos. He's writing at a time when Israel was too complacent. The rich were oppressing the poor. Those who had did not show compassion to those who did not have. And definitely, as you listen to this word, you may be saying, "Oh, today those who are rich are going to suffer in the word of God for today, and those of us who are poor are going to be defended." But you know, there are times that all of us behave like selfish people, because you know, not every rich person is selfish, and not every poor person is generous. Generous in character, generous in dealing with other people. Look at the condemnation of Amos. Amos says, "Hear this, you who trample on the needy and bring the poor of the land to an end, saying, 'When will the new moon be over that we may sell grain, and the Sabbath that we may offer wheat for sale? That we may make the ephah small and the shekel great and deal deceitfully with false balances.'" Now, who is boasting here? The one boasting may be anybody who wants to gain from the innocent. So he's not just castigating the rich here. Amos is castigating anybody who is trying to gain using dubious means. Anybody who is trying to become rich using dubious means, he is castigating every corrupt person. You may not have a lot. You are planning to have a lot at the expense of the helpless. You are planning to expand your territory using the needy, taking advantage of the needy, taking advantage of those who are helpless. Amos is on you today. When you tell people, "I'm just doing this because it is a Sunday," you are lucky because it's a Sunday today. I would have insulted you. He's talking about the periodical Christians, the believers who are only believers because it is a day of the Lord. We are many who try to look very nice on a Sunday. We put on a uniform. We go into church and we speak with such decency that those who look at us just think that that's how we are. But come Monday, we are hooligans. Come Monday, we are oppressing everybody else. Come Monday, we have deals that only the devil knows about. And of course, God. Come Monday, we are so destructive. When will this Sunday be over so that we can continue doing things the way we have been doing them? Amos wants consistency. And this is my preaching to you today. Your faith is not only on a Sunday. Your faith is not only on the day of the Lord as you call it. That's why we have daily bread, to remind ourselves every day, to remind ourselves that our Christianity cannot go off duty. Our Christianity can never be on leave. We are ever on duty, and that every day is the day of the Lord, and that the way I would conduct myself at church is the way I'm going to conduct myself when I am with other people outside the church circles. I'm an ambassador for Christ, and that ambassadorship must be seen in the way I conduct myself at every moment of my life. Look at Matthew. Matthew is called from the tax office. And after being called, Matthew was never the same. Matthew decided to call all those he was having deals with. He called them to come home because he had met the Lord. Because he had met him who changed his life. And from there, Matthew's life became different. He became an evangelist. The gospel of Matthew is attributed to him. The man who experienced the mercy and love of God. And having experienced the mercy and love of God, he could not leave out any of his friends. You have experienced the mercy and love of God in your life. Where are your friends you were drinking with? Why are you selfish? Why do you want to keep this faith to yourself? Bring them to the Lord as well. You have changed. You are a new person. And let this newness not be selfish newness, but generous newness, so that you have all your friends, your fellow drunkards, your promiscuous friends. Let them all come to the Lord. Let them all come and dine with the Lord. They should have a chance of receiving Holy Communion, of coming back to the sacraments. That's exactly what Matthew did. I don't know what you are doing. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Friday to you, and happy new month of July.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm lost without you. God bless.